Anyway, moving on. So we are going to get, like I said, Wanderlust Grand Finals. So I think this is, I have no idea if this is best of five or best of three. I guess it's best of five.
Yeah, apparently it is.
That's embarrassing. That shouldn't be a question, but whatever. Anyway, so Don and
so we got 9 Feind and Ball of Doom.
Yeah, Dimefront and Ball of Doom on the eastern side, Sprung and Don on the western side, and I think Dimefront and Ball of Doom. Okay, Ball of Doom to the north, interesting. Dimefront probably going to the center. What are we going to see? We're going to see spies, we're going to see cloakies, we're going to see gunships. I'm guessing the first match is going to be a lot of cheese. Because it's like best of five, well, let's just get this over with. At least the first couple matches, you can cheese it out because you're still fine, you're still safe. Like, if you lose it, you still have another couple matches you have to lose before the game's over. But, I don't know. We'll see. Best of three, I think, is still... I don't know. I'm not going to complain anymore. But I do expect cheese. But Ball of Doom going for Spiderbot Factory. Not going for cheese. Presumably. Are Don and Sprong going to go for cheese? Dimefront going for jump bots. So jump bot and spider, which kind of makes sense on this map. Don going for cloaky and Sprang going for something completely unknown. Oh, there we go. Okay, we begin and Sprang once again not starting with a factory. I don't get that. I don't know why they don't start with factories a lot. It's really weird. So early light units for the western side and sorry, eastern side and XCOM going for okay, Amphib and Cloaky.
Amphibs, what are you doing on this map? You have no business here. Go away.
Well, to be fair, Amphib pretty much works in every map nowadays.
Yeah.
So I'm not terribly surprised. But at least scouting is done. Well, Don has kind of been scouted. And I'm kind of curious. I can't really think of either player really favorite to win. They both seem relatively even so far. And in terms of their overall performance, it was relatively even. I mean, Dimefront and Ball of Doom were fourth place. And Don and Sprung, I think, were like second or third place in the Swiss. But then again, the undefeated and Swiss champion got third. So I have no idea what to think anymore. But it looks like we have a nice setup here for a defensive play from the eastern side. And the XCOM side, I mean, they're really pushing hard already. Three glaives and two ducks? This isn't a simple yes. raid. They're trying to win with a rush out, all just about win with a rush, or cripple with a rush at least.
Doesn't work. Defensive no. Pyro and LLT.
No, that didn't.
But it gave Sprang a bit of time to move his spider forward, and now he can build turrets.
Yeah.
On a critical location here. That corner is really hard to push someone away from.
Yes.
Because you have to get up that ramp and then you're immediately in line of fire of those turrets. You deny that super max to the other, or that bigger max to the other team.
Mm-hmm. So that was that's a nice opening for eastern side for Ball of Doom. I mean, really, really well done there. And that's going to be... Well, it should take a couple minutes or so. I mean, there's still a bit of time for that to turn around, but I don't think that the XCOM team is going to focus on that. I think XCOM is going to focus pretty much entirely on the spiders skating. Okay. Anyway, I think XCOM is going to focus more on the south. That's where they're focusing before, and yeah, they're still focusing on it. And it's not going to do them much good, sadly. Especially now that the north has been basically taken. East team's really getting off to a strong start here. Although XCOM team does have a slight economic advantage, militarily they're not holding their own.
Yeah, the strange, what are they called?
Well, actually, never mind. They are actually starting to hold their own.
Water gun archers.
Yeah. Actually, they are starting to hold their own. Never mind. doing more damage than I thought. Why is there no follow-up for Ball of Doom? I have no Reckless or anything. Or Redback. Oh, there's the Redback.
Doesn't
finally.
Need to.
Well, they kind of do, actually. Because, I mean, if you don't have the Redback, then you don't have any way of easily getting rid of Glaives, and then you lose your Venom, and that's it. Or you drag them into Defenders, and then they die. That works, too. Yeah, I guess.
So now Dawn can push forward to the bigger mechs. He has two warriors to back it up.
Uh-huh.
And the north large mechs hasn't been taken yet by either player. It was just the center one.
Nope. Sprang chose to pick the three at the top first.
Yeah, I kind of agree with that. It's just weird to take the middle on top of that. Yeah, now Dimefront. Okay, Dimefront on the south as well. So, eastern side trying to take the north and south. And then cut and push down into the center from there. That seems to be their idea. Not sure it's going to work, though. They have nothing to deal with the boys easily.
Spiders are not good at these skirmish type of situation.
No, they're reckless, they aren't.
Yeah, they don't have the meat, the hit points, the death ball effect. The other factories do that a lot better.
Yeah, although admittedly, fleas do help.
Nah, but they don't win you the fight.
Right, yeah, I mean, okay, with the commander there, that causes a problem.
You cannot overrun LTs and defenders with spiders. It's always very
hermit.
Costly.
If hermits, they exist.
Yeah, but it's costly and they die.
Well, okay, a lot of things cost money and die. I mean, hermits aren't that expensive. It's like 160 metal. As far as...
Yeah, that's what I mean. They die. You can't repair Zeus's and thugs are more durable.
Hmm. Okay, but then again, the spider, the shieldbot factory is about being durable.
Yeah. Ooh, nice. Warrior against EMP stuff. No.
Wait, where is this? I missed that.
No, it was here.
Oh, that was really quick then. Jeez, I was looking at the boys, didn't even notice that. Yeah, see, this is where the fleas work out just fine, because you have the boys completely defenseless. Although, admittedly, that was...
Didn't gain him anything.
That was a hermit. That was a couple hermits cost in fleas. Those are two or three hermits, that would have probably fared a lot better. And pyro attack over to the southwest as well, so East team not letting up. Just deal more harassment. Although, admittedly, XCOM has got way too much energy to worry about hitting their solar plants. They're not... The solar plants are not going to be really stopping anything right now if they're closed up. And the north side's been broken, so at least, I mean, I don't know, Ball of Doom had that. But now Sprang's taking it, so it's not completely secure. Apparently can be beaten. So Sprang over the north, trying to push that, and south side hasn't been taken. Really looks like XCOM team is securely taking the center, and I feel like they're in the lead in this game.
Yes, definitely. With this middle max added to it, yeah.
Yeah, once they get that on top of it, I don't know if there's going to be any easy way to push through. I mean, I don't feel like Dianfern's done a huge amount. They're building a Firewalker right now. They built a few support units with placeholders and such. A couple of jacks, a couple of moderators. They haven't really managed to get a whole lot of mileage out of that, though.
And that's an issue, I think.
I see this being a really big issue for them right now. They need to manage to get something out of this, because right now it's been a lot of money spent doing nothing. And their commander risking a lot here too.
There's a Jack trying to attack. It's got stopped by a solar panel.
Yeah, that sucks. It's like not able to do much, and the moderators weren't able to do much, and the Jack's not able to do much, and it's like nothing's really able to do much. Not for Dimefront, anyway. Their forces have been relatively ineffective. Ball of Doom... Oh, there's the moderators. They have done something. Ball of Doom has... I feel like they've been holding the line a lot more. And now at this point, the center's completely taken. XCOM could not quite just about push in yet, but I'd say in 3 or 4 minutes, they're going to have the resources and money to push in.
The amount of constructors that has built this game is surprisingly low. Everybody has at most one or two cons.
Yeah. Actually, no. Three now for Dinefriend.
Yeah, just three then.
I think they had a bit more earlier, but yeah, I see what you mean. Fair amount of caretakers, though, but it is not quite the same. Although at this point, I think both players, both teams are really focused on military. Probably more than necessary. I mean,
I see Crepe and a Firewalker. The big units are for the right side now.
Yep. Okay, so the Crab will at least help with getting through the defenses, but still, north side's been taken. Boys are still a pain in the butt, no matter how you run it. And
they always are indeed.
Other than that, what else is there? I mean, there is... Yeah, okay, there's the Firewalker, which is handy. It's going to help getting rid of the defenders, that's for sure. That'll get rid of the defenders, that'll be handy. And a Grizzly coming in on the western side, just been built. So that's a problem. That's going to have to be dealt with. And overall, this is... still really difficult. But hey, an opening! The southern side has actually started to break!
That's just one check. They had a nice exchange of HLT fires.
They did, but Dianfrons actually managed to take that. The north side, Crab helping out too.
Ooh, shifts! Those can be nasty now, because... there's a straight line. Nothing to scout it.
Yeah, there's... Okay, hidden side is definitely a problem. Firewalker got lucky,
look at
though. Wow!
What a lucky shot.
That was a really good shot. I mean, they didn't know there's a size there, but hey, that worked. Because we've been seeing size a lot. Like, this entire tournament, they've been sized pretty much every single game. Just to try to break in. They've become really popular. And for good reason. I mean, they're a quick hidden way of getting in. It's just, they come in, and with like two exceptions, they get spotted. Same with drops. It's like, every single drop has been spotted in advance, and it's the only reason.
Grizzly versus Crepe. Nice.
Okay, that still worked. Sites got rid of the factory. Not the most worth it, because factories aren't that expensive, but in terms of actual build power and the ability for the Eastern team to recover from that, that wasn't bad. On the other hand, the Scythe was still stopped. Like, it was still seen in advance. And XCOM team is way ahead. Like, from an even position, I wouldn't say that was the best of raids, but given the position that the teams are actually in, it worked well enough. And Dimefront going for another spider factory.
More turret wars.
Crab versus Grizzly. Grizzly
Oy.
Wins.
Crab dies.
Although versus Ooh,
get paralyzed now.
Ooh. It got paralyzed, but
there's nothing to finish it off.
Yeah, right after the red back got killed. So much for that. Good try, though. I don't know if there's anything more that the Eastern team has up their sleeves, though. I feel like that's it. I feel like they're just going to throw in the towel and try to save their energy for game two.
They also lost their Firewalker, didn't they? Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they did. Right here. Not really sure what they're going to be planning on doing. Reckless is for a bit of breaking, but otherwise I don't see anything.
I see two Grizzlies now.
Yeah, one of them is... Oh, yeah. Yeah, one of them is up front. One of them has just been produced. And an air factory just being built up for Don. Oops. But Don's just got the air factory up. That'll probably be, I'm guessing, Phoenixes, because that's usually what's built. Or they're going to go for Swifts, because they think... Actually, probably early Vulture, then... No, Raven. Never mind. Here, I'm wildly speculating. No, it's a Raven. That's all it is. Probably going to try to break some metal extractors. And gunship coming up. Okay, it could work. Gunship for Ball of Doom. Dianfriend is going for mass production Crab. While Dianfriend's going for the lighter units. Going for the Reckless Redback Venom.
Oh boy, that Grizzly. Oh, that spy.
Oh!
Has to climb.
Oh, I got spotted.
Run.
Infiltrator got spotted and stopped completely. Those things are awesome. Those, I mean, can't remember which game it was. I think it wasn't your game. I think it was the second game I saw in Cold Snap, where infiltrators killing Dante's.
Oh no! But there's no. There's a second. 26 seconds. Wow.
Yeah.
But can they kill it?
No. No, they can't. I think Grizzly's totally fine. Which kind of sucks, because that was a nice setup. Good infiltrator setup, but nothing behind it to really finish it off. So I don't know, I don't really see any way out of this, honestly. Not an easy way.
No, there's none.
So just save your energy for game two. You got at least two more games. If you get tired now, then you have no chance. Especially if you start making comebacks. Like, at least two games. If you win, you're going to have at least three. It's like, save energy. Save the energy. But now it looks like they're just going to be super tenacious and possibly burn themselves out this match. Ball of Doom. Okay, yeah. There we go. So game one goes to XCOM team. And game two is going to be the other team's choice of map. I'm guessing they're probably going to be choosing something. Let's see. Dying Sprang. Sorry, that's XCOM. Dying Friend and... Actually, I don't know what Dying Friend and Ball of Doom want. I really don't. I can't remember what they used earlier.
I'll be right back.
Okay.
So yeah, we're gonna have game two. Dying Friend and Ball of Doom have to choose their map. Are they gonna choose something? Are they gonna go? Okay, something just broke. Okay, they're going for Terra again. Oh, interesting. Okay. So they're gonna try to go for Terra. Which we saw already was, I mean, we saw it with the other team. We saw it with Kshatriya and Average Plan versus Sprung and Hokomoko. That's interesting, though. They're going to go for that. Okay. Oh, wow, a lot of people coming in to watch the tournament and not going to spectator slots. Come on. All right, so we have potentially two more matches. Ow. What the heck happened to... Why am I not... What the heck? Okay, apparently there was some weird lobby weirdness. This is really weird. And where has Don gone off to? Oh, Don must have... Falling out. Where is Don? Okay, so apparently we had some weird technical problems going on. Bit of a shame in that, but whatever. We'll sort that out as soon as Don
gets back. I'm back.
Yeah, we're just waiting for Don to get back.
Okay.
Because something weird happened with the lobbies. And Don, apparently, among others, got kicked out. Really strange. Where the heck? Okay, I imagine Don will come back as soon as they're back. So yeah, Terra. We saw it before, that's... interesting setup. We'll see, I guess, I'm guessing that Ball of Doom and Dime Friend are probably not going to go for the Super Mechs. I'm guessing they're going to go for more of a safer setup. Like, maybe one for the Super Mechs and one elsewhere. Rather than double Super Mechs. Though, I don't know. I really don't. I feel like it's gonna be a repeat of the last match we saw. The bronze match.
Oh yeah. Treypak, Spring, Bolodoon.
No, Treypak is just there because they should be spec'd. I don't know why they're...
yeah.
They're just being jerk. I thought I had boss. Anyway. Okay, now we're good.
Start!
There we go.
Ah, crash. Bam.
What? Okay, a bunch
of... do you want low details? No, I don't want low details. Why do you ask?
Ah, stupid thing just crashed, and now a bunch of people are... user not authorized to connect? What? That's really weird. Like the lobby's breaking or something.
Yeah, I've had it a couple of times today.
Oh, okay. Not sure what teams are what anymore, though. I feel like this is going to completely break everything.
Yeah, maybe just go to another host.
No, I mean, I don't think the teams are right at all. What the heck? Okay, no, that didn't work at all. And I don't know what's happening anymore. Why is there have to be so many technical problems with this game?
Maybe we should ask Blizzard to take over Zero K.
No, I don't see that working out. Okay, that was just weird. Okay, apparently remaking the room. That was just, I don't even know. Alright, sorry about that. That is being really weird. Ah, okay. Are we good? Are we good? We have everyone where they should be?
Well, it need to be here, I hear. So you can make the team start.
Just split the teams properly. There, can we start? I don't know why Sortel is doing the StarCraft countdown thing, but whatever.
Looks cool.
I guess. I mean, when the better lobby comes in, it would be kind of neat if that had a proper countdown, but yeah, with this lobby, it doesn't work. Okay, we're back in business. Sorry about that, everybody. I don't know what was going on. Apparently, everyone's lobby just sort of suddenly crashed. Which is a weird thing to have happen, but that's a thing sometimes. So it was Sprung and Dunn, that one. So we're on game two.
In case you didn't know.
Yeah, so we're in game two. Sprung and Dunn are in the south. Sorry, Bald and Dunn are in the south. Sprung and Dunn in the north. No clue where people are going to be building up right now. Looks like Diamond Throne is planning on going for the Super Mech. Ball of Doom is planning on being more in the back. Whereas to the north, I have no clue. Really hard to tell. I guess Sprung and Dunn must be in Mumble or something. That's why we can't see what they're doing or planning or anything of that nature. Because that's what happens.
Well, I can join Mumbles so I can hear what they say.
Oh, yeah, you could do that.
I can even bind it to the mic input.
That would be a bit excessive. I would rather not have that go all the way on stream just because that would be a lot of voices.
I guess so.
Ball of Doom going for gunship. Dime Friend on... Thanks, anyway. Dime Friend on heavy tanks.
I think it's even closer to the Super Mechs if you start here.
Think so, but there's no way to draw lines in here that allow you to just know how far away
you need
are.
Google Maps here.
Yeah. I don't know, that's a good question. Distance. Anyway, Don front very quickly going for heavy tanks up front. Don going for light vehicles up front. Sprung no factory at the start because they never do. Oh, amphib, okay. Gunships from Ball of Doom. So this is a very different setup from last time. No air. I mean, they have gunships, but no planes. Heavy tanks instead of hovercraft. And a... looks like a much more centralized focus. Although Dimefront getting attacked very quickly. The commander should be able to defend this, no problem. But at least everyone knows. The darts are there. They know. That's where...
Now they know. I didn't see the gunships yet.
No. No, the gunships being in the back is a really good idea. Although, wait, I don't know, the Banshees moved out. I don't think they were spotted, but they have moved forward.
No, they haven't seen them yet.
No, but only one so far. Bunch of cranes. Okay, it looks like it's going to be Banshees and then cranes for a little bit of additional expansion.
Should but one Banshee can't do anything. It dies to LTs and... defenders and ducks and darts and scorchers and
not darts. It dies to warriors and levelers and ducks. Maybe ducks. Not really ducks. Not really ducks. Scallops. They're not that fragile. Actually, this should work out fairly well. That one duck might be an issue, but yeah, it's strafing around well. So yeah, that works.
Oh, there we go. Duck ultimate AA.
Okay, so one Banshee doing okay. Ball of Doom getting killed scouted out, so the gunship plant has been scouted out. They know.
Yes.
Totally know. And heavy tank and gunship, I can kind of see the logic, but at the same time I feel like they're going to have a hard time actually covering ground. I feel like Diamond, like South Team, is going to have a hard time actually maintaining their territory just for the factories they picked.
Hmm.
But we'll see.
Those ducks will do marvelous.
Yeah, I mean, if Sprung can play him like Hokomoko, then yeah, those ducks do a really good job. But I don't know, Hokomoko is kind of an amphib specialist. They play amphib all the time. Sprung, on the other hand, seems to be much more flexible. And now a decent amount of Banshees coming in here. That will be able to do some damage.
He lost a Banshee, he didn't have to. Had to.
Well, second Banshee, yeah, definitely didn't have to. Sheesh. That could have retreated.
Oh, come on.
Desperately trying.
I'm not sure about Banshees in general.
Banshees have been really popular recently. They're not bad, but... Yeah, they are really
by popular. Definition, you're better off with a rapier.
Hmm. I don't know. I think there's.
Oh yeah, let's not lose my ourselves in fury crafting. I see a lot of ducks, and I see one lonely Kodachi.
That's not moving. Well, no one certainly not moving anymore. It's a wreck. All right, so two total Kodachis, two wrecks that were once Kodachis. Bit of a shame that. And overall, in terms of territory, it's about even. Neither team is really winning out, and actually the XCOM team, I'd say, is a little bit worse off. Hi.
Hold on, fine. This team has a bit more metal. they're a bit more active with expansion, but now Sprang got the second Supermax.
Oh yeah, and got back the first Supermax that was destroyed by the Banshees. I mean, that was why the Banshee was so desperate. Get rid of that Supermax.
Mm-hmm.
Because now XCOM's back on top. And this is going to be difficult to deal with. And it looks like, okay, Welder over to the Eastern Supermax. South team trying to even up the Supermax distribution. Which is a good idea, because that's a lot of metal.
But he decides to build the three defenders before the MX.
I don't know, the ducks will be able to power through the three defenders, no problem. So I'm not quite sure the motivation is there. I mean, actually, that mech, that super mech to the north is actually a plus 10 in practice due to overdrive. Same with the one to the west.
Jeez.
That's a lot of economy just from overdrive. On the other hand, South team hasn't really taken advantage of overdrive in the same way. So it feels like South team really isn't. I mean, their expansions are fine because they have a much more stable base of economy that's not super mech dependent. But their Supermaxes are nowhere near as well invested in as the ones for the north side. Or the ones for XCOM team. And now XCOM team trying to push in for, I guess they're hoping is the kill. Bit of defense too. Nice Panther raid though. Getting rid of a Supermax, getting rid of 10 metal per second, really swinging it back. I mean, that's the thing, is that South team, they don't have to worry so much about losing Supermaxes because it's not as swingy. Whereas North team or XCOM team, every Supermax they lose, that's 10 metal per second they're losing at least. Well, 5 to 10 metal per second they're losing. That's a lot of metal they've lost.
Hmm.
Like, it's difference between parity and slight advantage and being completely at a disadvantage. So nice raiding around the back. Looks like some ducks have gone around the back, raided out a bit. And over to the north, not much. But there's a lot of openings. Naked expansion, or just about naked expansion, means that you could see the XCOM team getting attacked to the north. Same way they're attacking to the south, so another Scorcher coming into the east. And more ducks as well. Look, they're going to try to come to the east on top of that. Yeah, Scorcher.
I would like to see one of those constructors at Sprang's base to start taking mechs.
At Sprang's base?
Yeah, one of these. To the left corner.
Oh, yeah, rather than just building the Grizzly. Especially with like minute and 27 left. Yeah, that seems like it would be a good idea. Although the Supermech has been rebuilt, so once again, Supermech with a bunch of overdrive back up and running. Still not the best of situations.
Remarkable how well you can do with ducks. It's I'm really surprised.
Well, that's what I was saying earlier, why Amphib is basically viable in every map. Because ducks have the high alpha and are relatively inexpensive. They're good units. They're really strong units. So it makes Amphib a relatively viable choice in every map. Ducks and boys. It's pretty much what's played. Sometimes scallops, but ducks and boys are the main line. You see that all the time, and then into Grizzly. Like, that's how Amphib just does its thing. Pretty much every single game that Amphib's in.
Oh, move, Dimepoint.
I don't know, I think Dimepoint's commander is sick of life.
Yeah, happens to all of us.
Yeah, it's a bit of a shame when it happens as you're being shot at, but what can you do? Still Supermax with some overdrive to the east, so it looks like South team is getting their Supermaxes to work for them pretty well. Not quite as hard as the ones to the north, but hey, it's still working. And defense to the southwest, more raiding from the southwest. I mean, I gotta say, XCOM team is working about as well as Sprung and Hokomoko at taking out the sides, at taking the flanks, and just generally harassing around. Although, admittedly, Dying Front and Ball and Doom are doing a better job at keeping their own terrain relatively well defended. So it's a much more even game than the earlier one.
Yeah, I guess so.
And then a grizzly happens. And then the grizzly's on fire. And then the burning grizzly just goes away. No, it's still going. It's still coming at you. Setting a grizzly on fire doesn't stop it that easily.
No, it's minimal, the damage it gets from a fire.
Yeah, it's got asbestos in its fur. It's perfectly fine. I mean, you know, except for the chronic asbestosis, but that just can't be helped. As for the Ragers...
Yeah, Ball of Doom is not really as active with rebuilding as Maxis. He's trying to, but it's slow.
Well, I don't know if they're really trying to. They got the cranes now. That works. I mean, it's not as bad as some of the earlier games. I don't think it was Ball of Doom that had the problem, because I actually haven't cast Ball of Doom, but... Oh, no, I have cast Ball of Doom. I don't think it was Ball of Doom, though. There was someone else who was having a hard time remembering to rebuild Maxis. I think it was Sprung, actually. Or maybe it was you.
Could be.
Yeah, I think it was you, actually. Yeah, I think it was in the first game. When you losing a bunch of mechs on the eastern side and they were just dead for a while.
Yeah.
Actually, I think both yellow players had a hard time rebuilding. Both you and... I can't remember who it was. I want to say it was... Actually, I don't know what I want to say it was. Oh, it was... I think it was Kshatriya, actually. That also had that problem. With rebuilding mechs. Because that's the thing to remember, is like rebuild mechs in your territory. But yeah, Ball of Doom's got that. They've got that taken care of. Not a big deal. I mean, the economy is actually relatively close. XCOM still has the advantage, but proportionally speaking, it's not a huge advantage. It's like 30% or so advantage. Definitely manageable, definitely something that can be played around and then swung around. Especially with the Super Mechs. If they can take out the Super Mechs again? Wow, how much overdrive is on that thing? Sheesh. Pushing in 12 energy.
10 metal.
Yeah. These... And then 12 from the one in the north. They, man.
Oh, yeah.
It's one hell of a grid. I mean, seriously, if they take out the fusion plant, which is inevitably... Or is there a fusion plant back here? I don't actually see a fusion plant. I might be wrong. No, it looks like it's just a bunch of solars and wind generators. There's no fusion plant at all, so there's no single point of failure. But yeah, managing to take out the Supermexes would swing this probably into South's favor. Though, quite honestly, I don't know if that's going to happen anytime soon. I mean, South... The XCOM team has just taken the center very strongly. South team lost the Eastern Supermex, and I don't think... XCOM's going to lose any of their Supermexes anytime soon. Not with all the forces they have protecting this. And double Grizzly coming in. Okay, one Grizzly down. Another Grizzly going to be going down pretty soon. Ducks raiding along the southwest. Or were.
They took out one Grizzly, but...
Well...
It was expensive.
Yeah. And the Ducks getting completely surrounded... Nice, it was an interesting harassment attempt, but not quite enough. Didn't really accomplish anything.
No.
Nothing at all.
But they've seen the geodome.
That's true. They did see the geothermal power plant. So at least that is a bit of knowledge that's there. Actually, is it geo? No, geo's not taken by the north side. XCOM doesn't have their geo plant. And they do finally have a fusion reactor, but frankly, that's not a point of failure at this point. And how much... Wow. Okay, it's not even that high right now, but... Once that fusion plant's up, that metal extractor is going to be 15 or 20 metal per second. It's going to be ridiculous.
They're bleeding units.
Yeah, so...
And the Grizzly can help but get taken out. Then they're done with both of them.
Okay, they're done with those two. I guess there's no Grizzly right now. There's no additional Grizzly right now. Kind of expected there would be, but
it's fairly even, actually. But there's a big amount of anti-air coming in now. To the left. Oi, oi, oi.
Yeah, those Reapers are going to go down. Ouch. That's
nice movement
well.
By Spring. Really nice. He saw that there was no cover of anti-air there, so you could just skirmish, flank those gunships. It's really, really.
I think that's it.
Good pickup.
I think that's it for Ball of Doom's gunships. Actually, I think they have to rebuild them now at this point. Yeah, they got nothing. They've got just Ravagers. I think at this point, XCOM might just try to. Well, I'm not going to try to push in. They can't quite push in yet.
No, not yet. However, those Ball of Doom of Ball of Doom. Ball of Reapers, Ravagers.
Mm.
The issue is just moved through the center now to sweep away those constructors. Help his buddy Reaper there.
I don't know if that's going to work. I mean, it's a good idea. It's just that brawler is way too intimidating.
No, it's just one brawler. Take the damage and take away the cons.
No, I'm not saying that as in it should be intimidating. I'm saying that it's clear that Ball of Doom is intimidated by the brawler.
Hmm. Yeah.
Like, it's pretty clear that they're scared.
After
of
a fight like this, you can expect the constructors to be there, so hunt for them.
Hmm. Well, at this point, I don't know. With the rapiers gone, another duck raid, like one duck raid will pretty much, or scorcher raid, whatever, that'll break it. And we see Scorchers already coming in along the eastern side. Coming into the back, it's totally naked in the back. Like
somebody's accessing.
Oh. I don't know, XCOM's trying not to. They're succeeding too. They're actually pushing a lot of metal into everything. Especially like 3.2 metal. My goodness. Metal extractor count. I mean, at least South Team is getting a bit of respite here. They might be able to take out the Western Supermex and Sprang's commander. Maybe. But over the east, you have the harassment coming in here, which, okay, the Reapers are helping with, but still. And the Ravagers forced back in the western side. Ball of Doom not able to really do much damage to the Ravagers. This is not what they want at all. I am sorry, Ball of Doom.
XCOM right now.
They just.
Wait, Licio.
Sorry?
To the left, Licio. Licio, Licio.
Oh, did I miss a factory? I did. Don's got this factory here. And they do have a Wyvern. And that Wyvern's basically idle right now. It's trying to find something to hit. It's looking desperately for targets. And at the same time... Wow, okay. Ravager Ball. That's all South Team has going for them.
Yeah.
That's the plan. It seems to be
counter. Boom, baby!
Wait, what just blew up?
The geothermal.
Oh, that was the explosion. Okay, the camera shook. I didn't see the explosion. Yeah. Oh, well.
It's only the first game, right? Or second one?
This is the second game.
I forgot.
XCOM 1-1. Okay. XCOM's up 1-0. So, if they win this, they only need to win one more and they'll take the series. And then if Ball of Doom and Diamond win the next one, they need to win two more to take the series. Or this one, potentially. I don't know how. But they need to win... Diamond and Ball of Doom need to win three at this point. Like, they need to win three in a row in order to win this series. Otherwise, XCOM will take it if they win next game. Or any game after this one, if XCOM wins this game, which I don't imagine they will lose. If XCOM wins this, they have to win... They can win any game in the series.
Oh, that's a dead commander. Nice.
Wow. Good Wyvern there. And it looks like Sprite...
Don is playing really well.
Sorry?
Don is playing pretty well. He has his economy game set up.
Yeah, Don's in a nice comfortable position. They only have to worry about just sending in bombing runs and everything else. They're just they're doing well in the support role. And Sprang is... Sprang's pretty much running a lot of the offensive. But then again, we've had a few Scorcher attacks. Slashes on defense... Well, sort of offense. But yeah, Sprang's definitely on the offense. Don's on the defense and support. It's working out well. Their teamwork's working out nicely. And at this point, looks like Sprang is going to be able to just push in. There's not much in the way. Ball of Doom's commander, about the only thing about to potentially block it, and that's at level 1, so good luck. Godspeed, commander. I can't say I pity you. Because that would just be kind of rude. Also, you die painlessly. But yeah, that's another commander down. And whoa, Swift's on the harassment attempt? I mean, hey, get rid of the geothermal plant. I guess that worked because... Oh, wait. Those are two geothermal plants. That's pretty much the entirety of South's energy input.
Also, yeah.
That's half of their energy, or a little over half their energy, is these two geothermal plants. So that'll probably break them, just for the lack of production capacity, and the fact that their overdrive is going to be completely shot. That's a good target. Of course, one thing I'm not so sure about... Yeah, okay, so that's gone. Ball of Doom. Okay, GG. There we go. So that's second game to XCOM. One more game, potentially. If XCOM wins the next one, that is going to be it. They will take first place. If Ball of Doom and Dimefront can win three in a row, they can run this back. This is run back time. They've got to win without losing. So, this is it. This could be it. I'm half expecting Ball of Doom and Dimefront to cheese it out. Like, I feel like they're just going to go, you know what? Screw it. What have we got to lose? But on the other hand, Spring and Don might cheese it out because they might go, you know what? Who cares if we lose? We can win this game or the next game.
They've got two rush cheesy attempts at winning, and then they can play a good game.
And apparently ravaged. Okay.
Ravaged.
Back to ravaged. See if this works. Although it occurs to me that it's actually... Oh boy. So, I just realized Dan and Sprang didn't choose the last map. Nor did they choose this map. So, I don't know. I feel like Ravaged might work if Dimefront and Ball of Doom really play the map hard. Maybe. But I don't know. I don't really have a huge amount of confidence. I'm sorry, guys. But... Actually, you know what? No, I'm not sorry. Run it back! Run it back, Dimefront and Ball of Doom. Let's see what you can do. Because... That's what you got. You got... Three games. You gotta go. So let's... Let's get this going.
Don wants to drink. So do I. But I don't have to play.
I'm good. I had my tea.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm feeling kind of dehydrated. I'm going to get some water, so... Just, I don't know, talk for a sec, please.
1 second only, that's quick. Well, I'll just have my other drink then. Cheers. To anybody who's watching or listening. So anybody in the stream anyway? What's the delay?
All right, back. Thanks. Okay.
Yeah, I was talking for just 1 second. I would have wanted to talk more, but you explicitly told me to entertain him for 1 sec. So I'm really sorry.
You're worse than my fifth grade teacher.
How was your fifth grade teacher?
Oh, whenever we asked for a sec, he told us no sex.
Ah, but I gave you one.
True. Okay, so you're not quite as bad.
It was as if I heard some Russian or something on the stream, but that's not possible.
No.
Wait, you can hear all the noises I'm making, or what?
Yeah, I can hear your keyboard and such.
Ah, fuck, I didn't realize. I'm really sorry about that.
Oh. Also, you're breathing, but I wouldn't bring that up. I don't know. I know your mic situation is not the most convenient, so I don't want to bring it up too much. Okay, whatever. We have a game going. Game 3! On Ravaged. I mean, Ravaged. I don't know why I mispronounced that. I'm tired. I can't hear you at all now. Sorry, Floris. I cannot hear a thing you're saying.
You're not? Oh,
now I can.
I'm here.
Now we're good. All right. So, Ravaged. Still one of my favorite maps. Still kind of wonky in 2v2. But then I mostly play 1v1. It works fine in 1v1. Gunship for Ball of Doom. Yeah, Ball of Doom and... Ball of Doom and Sprung. Probably going to go for... Or Sprang, no. Ball of Doom and Dying Friend. Probably going to go for a drop. I'm guessing. Or maybe Blastwing Rush. But I can definitely see that they're... going for something a little bit cheesy, probably. Well, Time Friend's got the Cloaky Butt Factory.
Could J'adore de fromage.
Could be a Warrior Rush.
Oui. Le fromage. La fromage.
You know, masculine and feminine was always the part about French I never really could figure out.
Me neither. They say if a word ends with an E, then it's feminine?
Not necessarily. That's not even a hard and fast rule one way or the other as far as I know. But I mean, you're Dutch. Yeah. Doesn't Dutch have the same feminine masculine?
No. Well, it has something similar, but it doesn't follow any logic.
Okay, so it's worse.
Yeah, it's 10 times worse. It's also the reason why a foreigner cannot learn Dutch.
Right.
Because there is absolutely no logic to the how do you call it? The sex of a word?
Yeah.
Gender of a word.
Okay, well anyway, Blastwing into Crane, no cheese.
Blastwing versus Puppy, who wins? Who wins?
I think everyone loses because the puppy hits the Blastwing and then the Blastwing bursts into flames and then burns everything below it.
Uh-huh. They're cloaked. Jeez. Wow.
They burrow, yeah. Or were they cloaked in transit? I think they just burrow in transit. They burrow when they're stationary.
Hmm. Puppies don't. Or are they?
No, puppies do not burrow when stationary.
Puppies do splash damage.
That's true.
I didn't realize.
A little bit. But yeah, so at this point... not a whole lot of damage dealt by the gunship, but then Banshees are going to be coming in, and those could be dangerous. Especially now that the Blastwings have seen everything, so Ball of Doom perfectly knows what the opponent's up to. What are you doing?
I don't know.
You're making a popping noise with your mouth. It's really weird.
Am I?
Yeah, you're going.
I think it's one of those Windows thingies.
Oh.
Never mind.
Okay, anyway. No, rapier instead of banshee? Okay, one banshee, and then I guess rapier from there on out? What the heck are they doing? This strategy is not making much sense to me. Rapier and warrior kind of make sense. Blastwing made a lot of sense. Banshee, random
Everything
banshee.
Everything so far makes perfect sense to me. I don't see any issues.
Random banshee makes sense to you?
Maybe a bit excessive rush attempt with the suicide units. One would have been enough just for scouting.
Oh, you mean the early blast wings or the units being sent
Yeah.
Out?
Oh, boy.
Oh, hey.
Warriors so good against Pyro.
Yeah, okay. So the Northwest at least has been taken pretty well by the Southwest team. That's a good thing to have. Still, let me see. Sprang's already taken the Southeast. Ball of Doom's going to have a harder time building up. I mean, at this point, Ball of Doom is building up the rapiers. How many rapiers do they have? Two. Well, one and one in production. Against boys.
Angler. Yeah, repair those ducks. Mr. Don? Can't you move those amphibs around the outer ring of this map?
If you were to terraform down a ramp to reach the outer ring of the map, yes.
Okay.
But otherwise,
I'm not sure
no.
if that was the, that was Spring's intention. I doubt so.
No. The only reason I've only ever seen occasionally someone build a ship factory in the sea area around the map, like once or twice. It's very rarely done, partly because it's very difficult to get these ships around. There isn't much room to navigate ships around. And partly because at that point, what are you even going to hit? Like, it's hard for anything to actually shoot above. Crusaders and Enforcers might be able to, but it'd be a tough shot. Anyway, raiding coming in for Ball of Doom. Finally getting in some of the energy. Kill some of these wind generators. That'd be really good. Unfortunately for them, the anglers were already prepared. Fortunately, there's only one. Still not getting rid of this.
Yeah,
power.
It was just. You should just retreat now. Too late. He lost one.
Yep. But it's into the water, so at least it can't easily be reclaimed.
The thing is, green, or dein Freund has took the left three maxes in the center.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Spring hasn't yet. On the other hand, they skipped the three maxes at. Lower right, while red took those.
Yeah, now with the XCOM team taking those southwest or northwest, like northwest center, I guess, mexes, that's not working out.
Ooh, this pyro.
Wow. 24 health. I mean, the warrior's going to kill it. If not the defender.
Yeah, or not.
Well, it's got another, at least one more mex. Maybe, oh no, it's going to take them all out. All the mexes are gone. The rapier will finish it off. But
it's totally worth it.
Yeah, for that kind of raid, when the economic positions are the way they are, hell yeah, that was an awesome raid. That worked perfectly. The center, however, has been taken, but by Dein Freund.
This time, Ball of Doom and Dein Freund are really ahead in eco.
They're about even, aren't they?
No. Or are they? Wait.
Yeah, they're like 35, 31. It's pretty close.
Yeah, the reclaim sometimes gives a bit of a skewed. Numbers.
Yeah, I would say it's within margin of error. However, the rapiers are going to be a bit of a problem.
Six of them, seven of them. Even a razor can't stop that.
No, but more importantly, at the same time, there's also warriors keeping stuff at bay, so the center is being taken as well. And the northwest is being retaken, because that pyro dying, there was nothing to follow it up, so that northwest area being retaken. Sprang's commander going down.
Oh!
Oh, is it? Yep,
yes,
going
in
down
mid-air.
In mid-air.
Wouldn't have been better.
Nice shot. And yeah, that razor.
Razor kiss in slow-mo.
Not doing anything. So the southeast being taken out. Sheesh. Dimefront and Ball of Doom are playing serious. They really don't want to lose this. I mean, they have to win every game. So this is a good start. This is a good start to a run back.
Now, quickly take those maxes in your area.
Take the south.
Usually when you think you're winning a fight, you should already have your constructor moving. Not you should give the move order during the fight. As soon as you think I'm going to win this, you should send it.
Yeah.
Not, yeah, I've won the fight, let's move a constructor. No, you move in, you see the units, you know up front I'm going to win this, and then you send the already sent the constructor.
Yeah, so what, I mean, XCOM team is kind of falling behind. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Lotus is trying to lock stuff out. I heard a Spectre. Ah, the Spectre belongs to Daimferin, though. Stopping those moderators from getting away from doing just anything they want. Definitely going for the Skirmisher game. I don't think it's working
out. That's fine if the map for a Skirmishers.
Yeah, but I feel like the Raiders is going to rip it to shreds.
Oi, oi, oi.
And the Spectre can get rid of the Raiders.
Or whatever the name is, Dominators.
The Anglers?
Moderators.
Oh. Yeah. Wow.
A disturbing lack of raiders.
Yeah, and XCOM has basically no army, but... I mean, at least Ball of Doom has the rapiers. Not quite raiders, but... They're performing the same task, essentially. Not to mention, the Southwest has taken the Southeast side. They've taken the South mexes. And they've taken all these mexes. They're actually pretty far ahead. And the reclaim to the center as well, so this is going very well for them. Wouldn't call it yet, but they're definitely doing pretty well for themselves right now.
Oh, no, the commander lives.
Yeah, there's no way to get that. There's no way for gunships to hit underwater units at all.
Not yet. You don't have those torpedo gunships in Zero K.
No. I don't even know what you're talking about. But
yeah, BA and XTA used to have that.
Oh, okay. I know there were torpedo planes. I didn't know there were torpedo gunships.
Yeah, they were like brawlers that dropped torpedoes.
Oh, okay. News to me, but cool.
Awesome. They were like, yet one of them and they would destroy an entire fleet if they wouldn't shoot back.
Hmm.
Like insane DPS. But that's a different game.
Yeah, and honestly, the underwater interaction with Zero K needs to be either revamped or taken out entirely.
Just don't play water maps.
Yeah, but water's the only way to make a map that has a nice border to it.
You can make a board, borders like Onyx Cauldron.
Yeah, that uses water.
Oh yeah, it does use water.
That is water inside the map.
But I think the South team has won.
Yes, they have. This will not be a shutout. So Daimferin and Ball of Doom starting the run back. We'll see if they manage to pull it off. I mean, they got two more games. They have to win both of the next games on XCOM's choice of map, on Sprang and Don's choice of map, both times. If they can do that, then we could see a game five. We could see a proper run back. Well done. Good gunship play. Definitely played the map well. Although I noticed neither team really went for jump bots. I mean, XCOM kind of did, but didn't go for a standard pyro jump harass strategy. And no one went for spiders. So I feel like that's rather unlike the game we saw on... I can't remember what it was. One of the Swiss games. Oh no, it wasn't Swiss games. But yeah, one of the earlier games. I feel like that was a bit of a mistake. Well, I don't know if it was a mistake, but... When was that? Oh, it was one of the semifinals games. It was the first semifinals game I was on Ravaged. So Don and Sprung, gotta choose a map. Oh yeah, and Sortel pointing out that the finalists, one of them was tied for fourth place and won a tiebreaker match, and the other one got to the position they are by having a draw on a match they lost. Like, they had a draw, and then 2 minutes later, had the game not had the 30-minute draw rule, they would have lost.
Oh, yeah, of course.
That was Sprang and Dan. They actually lost to Sprung and Hokomoko. Well, they would have lost had the game not been a draw because of the fact that the game just dragged on a little bit too long. And it wasn't, and the two times metal rule didn't quite play out, because it was like 19,000 metal of units to 12,000 metal of units. But anyway, where is the map choice? I see no map choice. They must be discussing it. Alien Desert. Okay. Ah, what the? Stupid. So we are on Alien Desert for the match four of the finals.
Alien Desert. Yes, yes, let's do it.
What? Oh, Alien Desert, yeah. It's like, what is this about dessert? Wait, I'm
what's the difference?
Well, one of them's usually sweeter. Sand isn't particularly tasty. I mean, I don't know. Maybe you have a nice big cup of silicon every time you want to treat yourself, but that just doesn't do it for me.
The last time I did that, I must have been 8 years old or something.
Last time you ate sand? I don't think I ever did.
Sand cakes.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I mean, it's not as bad as eating glass, but it's pretty close.
Did you never bake sand cakes?
No. No, I did not. I don't think I ever ate sand.
You missed something.
Also, wouldn't baking sand cakes literally make glass?
Maybe it's the wrong word. I don't know. What do children always make these sand cakes?
I mean, I guess if you're imagining
on the beach or when you're playing.
Oh, okay. So you're
in the playground,
padding together a bunch of wet sand.
And then you say, "Ooh, mom, look, it's a cake."
Oh, okay.
And there's a
because no, if you were to actually put that into an oven and heat it up, you'd end up with glass, I think. And
you're just a bunch of sand.
Yeah, and shredded glass is not a breakfast cereal. It is not the breakfast of death sport champions, even though it sounds like it.
No. No, no.
Anyway, it looks like we... Okay, so...
Ball of Doom!
Ball of Doom going for slightly proxy Light Vehicle Factory, and... The XCOM team also Don going for another really proxy Light Vehicle Factory. Not at all defensive.
This is where I lost my game with El Torero. We should have won this one on this map with this strategy.
With a proxy Light Vehicle
I didn't
factory.
See it, but we did 6 Scorchy Rush against someone who proxied his factory in the same position Don is doing now.
Mm.
And at Commander lived with 30 HP, and then we lost the game.
Like you attacked, you're the one that was...
Attacking, yeah.
Okay,
attacking.
So you weren't proxying.
No. But because really, in this position, if the other team decides to just build 3-4 Scorches and move forward, you're dead.
Yeah, but let's get Northeast as being a little more cautious, starting with darts rather than Scorchers, and starting with welders. So, not going for cheese.
We set it up like I started here, and then the other El Torero started here. We set up all the... supported each other's factory, and then we had a lot of Scorches.
Okay. So kind of like that Icy Shell game.
Kind of like that, yeah. Other than small micro mistake and... Commander lived. If the server would have been in the Czech Republic, then we would have won it.
Yeah, but it's here.
It's the best excuse I can come up with.
Yeah, it kind of sucks that the lag is so high that even if rollback netcode worked for RTS games, it wouldn't be feasible just for the sheer fact that units would look like they're teleporting unless you set a limit on like 100 milliseconds. If you only reduce the lag by 100 milliseconds or so, which wouldn't be a massive reduction.
Because if I understood it correctly, the server has moved, right?
Yeah, it's in Canada. It's, I think, in Ontario somewhere.
Did you organize that?
No, I had no idea what was happening until it did. And that's Eastern Canada. I'm in Western Canada. I'm 3,000 kilometers away. Like. Anyway, lots of slashers. Lots of slashers. Sheesh, just pure slasher push. But Don's only in the center.
Oh.
Sorry?
Yeah, I find it funny that you have two of the same factories on this map, both vehicles. I would have at least expected one to be tanks.
Yeah, or gunships.
Yeah, something like that. Vehicles and tanks used can actually work pretty well.
That's the meta, really. But nope, this is all slashers. All slashers all day.
If you really spam them, if you can get 20 of them, it becomes a different game.
I think that's the plan. I mean, it's pretty clear they're pushing. Oh, they were pushing them. No, it's now Ravagers. Okay. Don and Sprying, both double Ravagers. Just.
I would like to see that, by the way.
20 slashers?
Start on this map and just to only take your first 6 maxes and then make only slashers for 10 minutes. And then start expanding and while you keep pushing forward your slashers.
I feel like.
I think you can even stop a Reaper with 20 of them.
It'd be interesting if it worked, but I feel like you'd be killed first. You wouldn't be able to get that far.
Oh boy. Stop, Slasher, stop.
Ooh. Yeah, those.
The Kodachi police is.
Those Kodachis.
Yeah.
Well, that's working. I mean, the other problem is that if you did that, what you're suggesting, your opponent would just take the rest of the map.
Yeah, but they cannot ignore 20 slashers pushing forward.
Well, yeah, when they're pushing forward, but as you're building up, spending the time to build them up.
Yeah, it's one of those weird dynamic games, but I think it's worth a try.
I could see maybe if you have the right stuff to protect it to get your opponent to respect your army enough that they don't expand too much. Then yeah, I could see it working.
The concept of picking fights without losing units. You sacrifice economy, but your army will never shrink.
Right, so play it like Clone or Golda.
Yeah, exactly.
Ooh.
But without the micro.
Well, yeah, because it's microing slashers, what's that?
Yeah, just set target. And hitting the S button when you want them to stop moving.
Well, actually, you use the fight command for that.
Nah, I stopped using a lot of the AI in 0K. I'll set targets on every unit individually and give every move order individually. I don't trust anything anymore in 0K.
Yeah, I can kind of see that.
But after the 5-minute mark, it becomes impossible.
Well, that's actually one of my big problems, too, is that it's not so much because I don't trust it. It's because I'm not... I don't know. I never really got used to it. Despite all this time, I'm still... I love line move, but I've still just gotten so focused on... Well, I have stuff I want to move around, and I have things I want to specifically target, and I'll just do that, rather than trying to get fight to work the way I expect it to. I've been getting
that's
used to
it. Really nice attack by Don, by the way, with those ravages.
Yeah, over in the north.
That was a really opportunistic move of Baladoom. You can't expect that to work.
Well, I mean, yeah, they're naked expanding, and Baladoom is naked expanding a lot, but to be fair, the Northeast team is just expanding a lot. They're actually taking a lot of territory, and it's not that naked. They have a decent amount of defenses up at the front lines. Don's attack was definitely keeping them honest.
But if you move 2 constructors to this metal extractor, you cannot expect that to work at this point in the game.
No, I mean, it was...
Unless you, if you send 3 construction vehicles, you have metal in store, and you prioritize LLTs, and you can set up 5-6 LLTs, and then you can set up the maxes.
Yeah.
But not expect them to move in, build maxes, and like you usually do.
Well, I think Ball of Doom was just trying to cheat out an expansion, and basically Don just kept them honest.
Because, exactly, and he paid for it.
Yeah.
Because that was quite an investment.
It was a decent investment, but I think it was probably...
I think it's 500-600 metal. It's almost a Reaper.
True. That could be a problem later on, especially with Reapers being built right now, but I think...
But now both teams are very passive.
Yeah.
They have a split line. They split the map, and now they just... Let's see where it goes from here.
Well, we do have Dianfern going to the north trying to raid out, as well as trying to raid out to the south. It's trying to split up again. Not quite the Sprung and Hokomoko coordination of splitting up. Actually, it looks like it's more a problem of trying to make sure that the south is kept defended.
Yeah, they trade blows.
And the Ravagers once again south. Being lost. I mean, not lost. Ravagers killing everything. Everything else being lost thanks to the Ravagers. And once again, Baladoom trying the north thing. What the heck?
They win both the fights. XCOM wins both the north and the south fight. I didn't expect
that. Yeah.
And they're just going mass Ravager. The entire time is all Ravager all the time. I'm a bit surprised that we haven't seen any Scorchers come in to try to counter the Ravagers directly.
It's hard. Really, it's hard. Ravagers are not that bad against Scorchers, and Scorchers are not really raiders in the general term.
Yeah, and then I guess your other option would be Panthers, I guess, but those die quickly enough. They aren't that much cheaper either.
Ravagers are not that bad against Scorch.
They're more expensive than Ravagers, come to think of it.
Aye. Okay, big ball of Ravagers now in the north.
Yeah, that's going around in the south. Looks like the south
can be LT up. And they can't win this fight.
I think that's going to be it, actually. They need to, if they can stop the north Ravager ball, then they're
this
okay.
This is where you need to tick. Come on here. Come here, Torero. We need your ticks.
Oh, yeah. El Torero's godlike ticks. That was so cool to watch. I mean, I realize you guys lost the game, but man, that was the best way to lose the game, is just ticks everywhere, holding out in the best way possible. That was awesome. I mean, admittedly, Panthers kind of work like ticks when they die. Really bloody
expensive. I would
love
to play more with... Oh, that's not... boom, 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 boom. No, they won't. That's what
nice
I call
awesome reaction.
Reaction.
I gotta say.
I'm impressed.
Yeah, well done, Dinefriend.
Dinefriend?
Although, unfortunately, they walled off their factory. Which, while it seems smart at first, becomes a bit of a problem when you realize your units have to get out somehow. But I guess in this particular battle, it's probably okay. The Reaper's not going to get out in time.
He also lost his commander now. That's a bit of an issue.
Oh, yeah. Well, it was a valiant effort. The run back effort was a valiant effort, but I don't see it continuing.
Stumpy wins the game.
Yeah. Although I must say, that was pretty awesome blocking out the factory. It's just, I mean, sorry, blocking the factory, blocking out the fusion plant. Like, if you could block out the factory, but not the entrance, that would be perfect. Which I guess would be terraform up and then terraform down the area right in front of the entrance so that units can get out. But yeah, that was... Oops. That was funny, but unfortunately not that effective. Especially since the factory ended up dying.
Yeah.
Didn't get terraformed up enough. Oh well. I mean, they're not totally dead yet, but I don't see any easy way for Northeast team to be rebuilding themselves.
Me neither.
They're trying. They have the reclaim. Or they have reclaim. I don't know about the reclaim, but they do have some reclaim.
They need to reclaim to keep up with the base income of XCOM.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, they have the welder. That's 7.5. They could build a couple more, or I guess rebuild the tank factory. Build a couple more. And the Wolverine's not going to soften up those Ravagers enough. This is it. This is game. These Ravagers coming in here, Dawn's Ravagers are going to pretty much take this. There's no defenses after this. Two more Ravagers is not enough, and that is it. After this, it's going to be Ball of Doom's factory down. Dinefriend just rebuilding their factory over to the south, actually. But that's been spotted, and it's going to be taken out pretty quick. Scorch is ripping that to shreds. And there's no other defenses, no other economy. This is game. I think Dimefriend's holding out until their factory's done, trying to do what they can. But I don't know what they could even build. And neither does Dimefriend. And that is game, that is match, that is tournament.
GG.
Well done, however, to Dimefriend and Ball of Doom for not getting shut out. I mean, they took a game, at least. So, there's that. It wasn't a complete shutout. So yeah, well done there. And that was good. I think that worked out okay as a tournament. I mean, there's definitely going to be some growing pains as a result of it being someone who hasn't done a lot of tournaments before. But hey, I think it worked out pretty well overall. We'll just have to work out rulings for some of the edge cases that are brought in by a draw rule. Because those produce some weird edge cases. Yeah, so congratulations to Sprang and Don. First place, Don from Ball of Doom in second place, and Sprung and Hokomoko in third place. Well done. And
yeah, they can pick some Steam keys as a first prize.
Right. That is the prize. I probably should have pointed that out. So the prize, for those of you who weren't aware, first prize gets to pick two Steam keys and gets 50 in-game kudos currency, which is basically just like a clan banner. And then the second prize gets second pick, and third prize gets last pick of basically Zenbound 2, Case Story plus Binding of Isaac with Wrath of the Lamb DLC, Shank 2, Total War Shogun 2 Collection, and then some combination of XCOM and Civ keys.
Yeah, I think XCOM Clan already has the XCOM game.
Yeah, that's a bit redundant for them, but they'll probably take the other ones. And maybe the other clans will go, or the other players will go, maybe I should get the XCOM games too, and I'll be good like the XCOM players who won the tournament.
Oh, yeah. I should join XCOM too. I just bought those games not so long ago, actually.
Oh.
Through the same Steam event, probably. Or what was it? What did you call it? Where you can pay anything you like?
Humble Bundle.
Humble Bundle. Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
You could get a lot of good games if you...
That's true.
Yeah.
But I'm...
Including XCOM.
Yeah, I have enough games right now because I have games to practice for fighting game tournaments, and then I'm going to be doing the Let's Play of Dark Souls 3, so I have that. That's going to be coming up when you know, April 12th happens. And... That's going to be enough games for a while. So I'm good. But yeah, Humble Bundle is always nice. Anyway, so those were the prizes. It's up to the players what picks they want of those. But yeah, that's it. So thanks for watching. That is the whole tournament. That is everything. Final results are just about because apparently they didn't decide to update the actual last win to show that Sprang and Dan won. But Sprang and Dan did win. So well done to them.
Yeah.
And that
congrats to Sprang and Dan. And I was really impressed by Polar Doom and Dying Freund. They had good games. Thanks a lot for all playing.
Yep. And thank you all for watching. Thank you all for helping me co-commentate, Floris. And
yeah, always a pleasure.
Have a good night, everyone.
Yeah, have a good evening, everyone.